booted away. Looks like he's going to try to return it. And the return man is stopped, and that'll leave it up to the offense on the next drive. So West Virginia's will have some work to do after that short return. And when you take the field with the confidence, the swag that this guy does, David, it just really elevates your confidence in the passing game.
That receivers don't usually lack confidence, and those are the guys that kind of set the tone. And that swagger sets the tone for this offense. And, Jesse, you know he's going to make plays.
And that speed scares defenses, too, because he can take the top off quick. These safeties better get back deep or else this guy's going to take it to the house.
Good spot after that 7-yard pickup on first down. It's 2nd and 3. Back to throw. It's Green. Finds his big tight end. Really good job to pick up a chunk of yardage and get it out to the 39-yard line.
Well, this tight end, he's got size and he's got some athleticism, and he's very difficult to cover one-on-one. Defense is going to have their hands full with him today.
The Mountaineers will hustle to the line. Running back searching for a hole. He's dropped behind the line of scrimmage. That'll be a loss of 3. Most offensive schemes are predicated on first down productivity. That will not go down as a productive first down play.
No, it will not, Reese. Give this defensive line credit because they were able to get penetration right off the snap and force a negative play.
He wants to throw here on 2nd down. With the catch, it's Gallagher. They bring him down, but a solid pickup to put them in position to pick up a 1st down.
One of the most difficult things about this slot receiver is his shiftiness and his athleticism. He's very, very difficult to tackle after the catch.
Let's see what they find in the playbook for 3rd and long from the 43. From the gun, wants to pass. Just too much juice on that one as he airmails his receiver out of bounds.
Well, they try to throw for it there on 3rd down on the opening drive of the game. They don't get it, but let's punt the ball away. Let's trust our defense. And, guys, let's also trust this home field advantage and the crowd to get loud and make it real difficult on our opponent.
4th down, and the punt team sends it the other way. And the punt hits at the 8 and goes into the end zone for the touchback. As we take a look at our impact players for this one, what are you looking for, Jesse, for a guy to make an impact?
Well, these are simply put the leaders of this football team, and generally games go how these guys play. If they make plays, then they've got a shot to win this one.
No doubt. They got to show up. These are the team leaders. These guys have to play well if they're going to win the football game.
Found a little bit of running room, knocked down at the 24 after a pickup of 4.
It's just simple. Simple first down run, showing your physicality, setting your offense up in a good spot.
Solid pickup of 4 on 1st down and 2nd and 6. He's looking to throw. Gets it out quickly. Wrestled to the ground after picking up the 1st down. That was a nice pickup, running the drag route and finding that quiet, soft spot in the zone.
Yeah, drag routes not only work against man coverage, they work against zone, too. If you can find the soft spot and the quarterback gets it to him early, he can turn up field, and you saw that right there.
With a 1st down, they'll snap it from the 32. He's going to pass. It falls incomplete, and that'll be the final play of the period. Defense has dominated the early part of this game, and the stats point that out emphatically. Sometimes you see the offenses sort of settle in, find areas to probe after that 1st quarter. They'll ride the running back and leave it with him. Really nice run there. Good, solid pickup, and they'll move the sticks with a 1st down.
And I don't care if I get it by 2, by 20, by 30, by 40. I just want to get the 1st down, understanding the situation, understanding where the sticks are. Doesn't have to be sexy, but I got to make sure I get to that stick, get to the 1st down mark.
They've been very sharp on this drive so far. Now first and 10 from the 43. The pass is incomplete, but there's a flag in the backfield, and that shot the quarterback took might have been a little too much. Just an ill-advised play by the defender to make contact with the quarterback after the throw, and it cost his team. Got it. In the middle, it's Young.
And that's a good job by the drag route there, understanding its zone coverage. So instead of continuing to run across the field, he settles down into an open spot, making it easy for his quarterback.
Second down here, and maybe they've got time to get one more snap off before the two-minute warning. We'll take a quick break as we have reached the final 2 minutes of the first half. They'll line up for a second down play. He's looking to throw. That's reeled in. It's Young. He stopped at the 32-yard line. Pick up a 5 on the play, and it'll be a first down.
And I love working the slot receivers, and you see so much of that. It's about matchups, right? I can put a fast guy in that slot, maybe get him matched up on a linebacker or a safety. I like working those guys in those matchups. Favorable for the offense for sure.
They're down to the 32-yard line on first and 10. Pressure coming. Hit hard just as he released it on first down and just couldn't get it to the receiver.
The offensive line has got to give him at least a little bit of time to survey the field. He had no chance that time, getting hit almost immediately after he got the ball.
After the incompletion, here comes second and 10 from the 32. Misfired on the last play. They'll go back to the air. He finds his man. Nice pitch and catch there, and they'll have enough for the first down.
Nice job by the receiver there, running the drag route against zone coverage, finding the soft spot, making it easy on his quarterback to get the completion. He turns it upfield, and he moves the sticks.
They're down to the 20, first and 10. They're looking to pass from the red zone. Into traffic, gets picked off, takes it the other way. He's at the 40, at the 20, and he's gonna take it all the way. Touchdown Mountaineers! What a play by this defense with the pick six.
And how about the defender? Exactly what you're supposed to do. Breaks on the football, makes the interception. Everybody on defense, we turn to offense. Go lay some blocks so my guy can get it and take it back to the house.
To attempt the try. And with the extra point, they get the first 7 of the game. So they got the touchdown, and as they kick off, really important for the defense to shut them down here. He'll bring it out. It's Hardy. Didn't find any crease in that kickoff coverage, and he'll be stopped at the 17. Looking for a productive play on first down. They're going to throw it to start the drive. And he just flat dropped it. I think he wanted to run before he secured it.
You know, it's difficult for QBs sometimes when you're throwing to your running backs because they're not receivers. You really got to be perfect with the ball placement. You got to make that a catchable throw. A little bit too tough for the RB on that.
Now on second down. They'll throw again after the incompletion. Got his man down the middle. Really needed a play like that to get out of their own end. They move the chains. They mark it at the 29. A timeout is called as this offense tries to find a way to get more points on the board before the half. He's looking to throw it. Getting some heat. Got his man on the outside. Here's a timeout on the field. Tight game here late in the first half. You know, sometimes even a short game like that can be used to set up something bigger later on.
No doubt, Reese, they can pump that and take a shot down the field. And don't worry, they're going to go back to that same play because they know this guy with the ball in his hands is dangerous. He makes one guy miss, he can take it to the house.
The offense wastes no time getting the timeout call. From the 39-yard line, it's first and 10. He wants to throw. He's going up top. And they dialed up a shot play, but they couldn't make the connection.
And the quarterback receiver just not on the same page on that last play. Timing has got to be so critical, especially when you're throwing the perimeter of the field. They just didn't have it there.
The incomplete pass leaves him with second down. He's looking to throw. It's complete on the right side. They get him down after he makes a catch.
Yeah, he threw a little hitch route. Nice job getting the ball out of his hands quickly. Wide receiver, quarterback. Nice job being on the same page. Nice completion. Nice catch.
One snap coming before they head to the locker room. We've played two quarters here. Time to go to Kevin Connors in our halftime update.
Gentlemen, what a pleasure it's been to watch these two teams thus far there in Morgantown. And it's been said football is a game of inches, and guess what? Based on the comparison between third down conversion rate today and the average yard per play, how can you argue that? I mean, the low-lying fruit is to look at some of the explosive plays we've seen and panic. But really, this game is going to come down to which team is more efficient when they have the ball and how they play when it matters most. With that said, let's send it back to the guys at Mountaineer Field.
And the Mountaineers will kick it off to start the second half. Fielded in the end zone, it's Hardy. I imagine he's going to get an earful on the sideline after bringing it out of the end zone and being knocked down at the 11. They'll come out on this drive and let it rip. And he is snowed under, sacked at the 7.
You spread me out, I'm going to speed you up. Nice job. They go empty. Nobody in the backfield to help the quarterback block. The linebacker comes right up the gut, gets the quarterback, gets him on the ground.
A first down sack can wreck a drive. Let's see what they've got on second and 14. He's looking to throw. And he was hit just as he released it, and it falls to the turf.
And that was good defense again. And unfortunately, we've been saying that all game long. Really, really good defense. Or, listen, you can spin on the other side. This offense has really been bad.
You make up the game plan and not a lot on the play sheet for this. Third and long from inside their own 20. Just threw that one away to avoid disaster. Looks as if we have an injury on that last play, and we'll take a break to check him out. They bring the punter onto the field now. Getting our first look of the afternoon at the punter. He will make the fair catch just a few yards shy of midfield. West Virginia has it in the offense ready to go to work. Man, oh man, these offenses just haven't been able to find any room to get things going, David.
And to quote the great philosopher, Reese Davis, this is very ungood. Just nothing working for this offense, Palmer. They got to find something.
Well, the plays look good against the scout team during the week in practice, but they have just not been able to find a rhythm against this defense today.
Ran the ball on first down. Let's see what they do on second. The give to the tailback. Gets away from one, finds room.
How about the patience from this sophomore to hunt that green grass?
Play about the speed back. You think about speed, you think about breaking ankles. He broke the tackle because he's so fast, moving so fast, hard to get the guy on the ground.
They've got it at the 37. It's first and 10. Looking to move it through the air. Snagged in the middle. It's Fox.
Hey, and quarterback receiver on the same page. Nice job seeing the zone, understanding the drag route concept. Easy pitch, easy catch.
After that last completion, it's second down. He's got it on the right. They're able to get him stopped just shy of the first down marker.
Great effort by the defense here. Offense trying to go wide receiver screen. How about the speed on defense rallying to the football?
They probably feel good about their field goal chances from the 29, but they'd love to convert this third and short. They'll try to run for it. Makes a man miss. He'll come through on third downs. He's got enough, and they'll mark it at the 23.
You know, you start day one of training camp running your base runs. You need a few yards, you run these plays. You need a first down, you run these plays. You rep them over and over and over again. They're not sexy, they're not pretty, but in the end, they're effective, and they get you that new set of downs when you need them.
They're going to go right back to him on first down. They get him down, and that'll be the final play of the third period. Guys, that's the end of the quarter, and West Virginia has the lead. They're sitting in a strong position here with the lead. Let's take a look at our game summary. One quarter to go, and Mike, we have the makings of a classic fourth quarter finish. Looking to pass. It's Green. Got his man quickly. He's close to the first down, but they're going to mark him just a little short.
This offense is not letting up, guys. They've got a lead here late, and they are still taking shots. They're still looking for explosive plays. This defense just has not had an answer here all game long.
This is as big a play as we've had in this game. Third down and 3. They keep it on the ground. Clock is their friend. The Mountaineers will have a first down.
Yeah, and if this offense can keep that rolling, if they can keep the physical ground game and continue to add these plays up as they go along, long drives, eat the clock with the lead, this coach will be ecstatic.
We have arrived at the 2-minute warning, a one possession game as this offense tries to hold on. Defense showing plenty of pre-snap movement of their own. And the Mountaineers will snap it on first and 10. Might as well give it to him again. And he rolls into the house. Touchdown, Mountaineers!
And you know, late in the games, offenses sometimes get conservative when they got the lead and they got the ball. I love this offense. They were aggressive. They got another score added to the lead. Now you're trying to salt this game away.
They'll try to add another to their lead. And the extra point is true, and they have a 2-touchdown lead, up 14 in the fourth. That last drive covered 52 yards on their way to the score. And the scoring play came on the 12-yard run. Lining up to cover the kick after that touchdown drive. He'll start the return inside his 5. He was hoping for something a little more dynamic, but they get him on the ground at the 20. Offense in a bunch formation. He wastes no time and comes out throwing. That's caught. It's Young. They immediately call timeout, trying to preserve every second they can to try to rally here late. Now here on second down, see if they keep tossing it around. He's looking to throw. They're trying to get to it. Nowhere close on that one as he got 12 trying to deliver the football, and now they face third down.
He didn't have a whole lot of time to get rid of that one. The defense was all over him right after the snap. No wonder that thing fell in.
Looking for that first down on third and short from the 28. Looking to throw for it. Can't make the connection on third down thanks to that tough, hard-nosed pass defense, and now it's fourth down.
After that incompletion, fourth and short now on their own side of the field, I think there's a lot of coaches in normal circumstances that would stay conservative and just punt the ball away. But you're trailing here in the fourth quarter. I think the offense needs to stay out on the field, and you got to go for it.
They'll go with the running game on fourth down here. And he's got enough for the first down. It'll be at the 35.
I know there are some people that say no. In your own territory, you punt the football, you be conservative. No, sir. Fourth and one, I'm hitting the gas. All gas, no brakes. I'm going for this. I prepared for it all week. Nice job by the offense getting the first down on fourth and one.
To the air on first down. And there was nowhere to go for this quarterback, and down he goes.
And man, it can be dangerous when quarterbacks get outside the pocket. They can stress your defense so bad. You better chase them. You got to keep running as hard as you can and try to get to him before he can throw that football, especially square those shoulders up. Nice job by the defense continuing to pursue, even though he got outside the pocket.
He's going to pass on second down. He's taking the deep shot. And just too much on that pass. Too high, too wide, out of bounds and incomplete.
Time is not on their side right now. They can't afford too many more incompletions like that. They need to come up with some connections, and they've got to score points. They've got to get this passing game going now.
Ball's at the 29. Defense can taste getting off the field. It's third and long. A deep throw as the clock winds down. And they can't hook up on the big play, and that brings up a fourth down.
After that incompletion, fourth and long now on your own side of the field, you're trailing in the fourth quarter. What's your go-to play call here in the passing game? Where is the matchup that you trust in to come up with a big one to give yourself a chance to stay alive and win this game?
On fourth down, looking for the completion. Here's a throw downfield late. It's incomplete, and they desperately needed to keep that drive going, and they couldn't make the connection. And on fourth down, they'll take a knee, but this one's just about over.